A stable lamp is lighted, whose glow shall wake the sky. The stars shall bend their voices, and every stone shall cry. And every stone shall cry, and straw like gold shall shine. A barn shall harbour heaven, a stall become a shrine. This child through David's city shall ride in triumph by. The palm shall strew its branches, and every stone shall cry. And every stone shall cry, though heavy, dull, and dumb, and lie within the roadway to pave his kingdom come. Yet he shall be forsaken and yielded up to die. The sky shall groan and darken, and every stone shall cry. And every stone shall cry for stony hearts of men, God's blood upon the spearhead, God's love refused again. But now, as at the ending, the low is lifted high, the stars shall bend their voices, and every stone shall cry, and every stone shall cry in praises of the child, by whose descent among us the worlds are reconciled. One thing I found by answering Richard Winslow's challenge was that if you write a hymn and you're serious about it, you have no business filling it with maverick notions of your own. A hymn has to be perfectly orthodox, so that a congregation can stand up and belt it out with one voice. And that's an interesting constraint under which to work, and of course, a great challenge. I'm glad to have met the challenge once. There are some people who, like Charles Wesley, who met it many times, and they have my admiration. Isaac Watts as well.